That just goes to show you, you're nothing but a whiskey delta. Lima, Oscar Lima. Lima, Oscar Lima.
Minions have spawned.
Lima, Oscar Lima. Lima, Oscar Lima. That just goes to show you, you're nothing but a whiskey delta.
Sortie!
An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain.
Another frag sortie!
An ally has been slain. Executed. An ally has been slain. Enemy double kill.
I'm on it, Black Shoe!
Thank you. go.
This is major time! Delta Sierra at 12 o'clock! Shit it yourself, Spank Nugget! Black Shoe!
An enemy has been slain. Double kill. Your team has destroyed a turret. Shut down. Destroyed a turret.
Thank you.
has
destroyed. Position. I just don't trust in them enough to say they will close out the game cleanly.
Well, that's fair. Dexter, earlier there was a little bit of talk about some of the support staff behind TSM, maybe, you know, giving them good advantages or how to read Ever's tower dive, pick some bans, some comments. Do you feel that's something that you agree with, you know, that TSM looked like they were very prepared in that first game?
I mean, I think you can only talk about like the first 10 to 15 minutes. It's like really scripted, especially in a lane swap. It's always the same thing, and it's really like, in terms of lane swaps, you always bounce back the wave and do it to the second tower. I think that's like really easy. But then, like at the 15-minute break part where TSM has like all this advantage in all the games, and I think it has been a problem like throughout the whole NALCS from the games I watched, that there's a point where they don't know what to do, especially with like Elite. And if they would just pause the game right here and had like a 3-minute talk with their coaching staff and analyst, I think they could just fix it and close out the games. But I think they need a bit more time to develop that into their whole play style. So, I mean, yeah, you saw like the Fat Fiora, and then they decided to not split push, which is the only reason why they lost that game, because yeah, that game was like super won, like 100%.
And yeah, the weird thing is, last year, one of the things Fnatic did extremely well was snowball their leads. They had Yellowstar as the guy making those calls. He joins Team Solo Mid. I don't think over the offseason he just forgets how to play League of Legends. He's like, I don't know how to push any advantage anymore. He used to play with Huni, who would split push in every single game, and he knew how to play around it, where to pressure, where to ward. So either...